It was one of the Prime Minister's key election commitments, and tonight, thanks to 60-day prescriptions, millions of Australians have access to cheaper medicines. There's now a truce with pharmacists too, who have suspended their campaign against the new model and hope instead to strike a new funding deal with the government.
Swallowing a bitter pill for her patients.
We have discussions with customers every day about being able to afford their medicines.
Pharmacy owner Sandra Farrington has seen thousands of families and the odd Prime Minister.
Hi, Sandra. How are you going?
But now, under Anthony Albanese's changes, her business will lose money. Labor's cheaper medicines scheme now allows 4 million eligible patients to request 60-day scripts. That's double the medicine for the same dispensing fee. Pharmacies have argued the cut to revenue will lead to job losses, reduced trading hours and even closures. Tonight, a temporary truce, the promise of a new pharmacy funding agreement by March next year.
What this agreement will do is it will ensure that Australians can have both cheaper medicines and viable community pharmacies.
We've been talking with them for some months now about arrangements for a new agreement to be struck, and I'm glad that we're going to be able to do that.
The sector hoping it'll include compensation and the ability to provide more health services. Until then,
we've had to review prices. We don't want to put prices up. We don't want to make the cost of living harder for people. But we also have to make sure we can keep our doors open.
The changes also aim to take pressure off GPs at a time when patient demand is outpacing availability and bulk billing rates are in decline.
Nationally, the share of bulk billed services was steady at around 80% before the last election. Reducing month after month, it's now at 76.6%, the lowest level since 2013.
We don't want to see Australians choosing not to go to the doctor just because they find it too expensive.
The government expects a boost in bulk billing from November 1 when new incentives for doctors take effect. Rhys D'Alessandro, Nine News.
The Greens are threatening to block Labor's plan to charge wealthy retirees more tax on their super. That's unless the Albanese government follows through on a commitment to add superannuation to paid parental leave.
What is the hold-up? Hurry up and stop making women wait for fair paid parental leave. The reward for a lifetime of care should not be to retire into poverty.
The government's accused the Greens of siding with the coalition.